let's solve some aromaticity problems. We have a two-part question here. We need to classify the compounds as aromatic, non-aromatic, or anti-aromatic, and draw the lone pairs on heteroatoms and determine if they participate in the pi system or are orthogonal to it. A heteroatom is a non-carbon atom, and orthogonal means the lone pair is perpendicular to the pi system. This is important because it cannot participate in the pi system when orthogonal. Maybe pause the video here and try to classify these compounds on your own. When you resume, we can solve the problems together. As a refresher, let's review the criteria for aromaticity. The compound must be cyclic and planar. In our examples, we have relatively small rings containing double bonds, so planarity is probably not a major concern in our problems, but it can be with larger rings. The compound must also be conjugated. The continuous pi system within the ring can be made up of sp2 hybridized atoms and lone pairs. Finally, the number of electrons in the pi system must satisfy Huckel's rule, having 4n plus 2 pi electrons. I'll abbreviate electrons e-. Now, if we replace n with 0 or small positive integers, we find that our pi system must have a specific number of electrons to be aromatic. We may also need to identify anti-aromatic compounds, which are cyclic planar compounds that have a continuous pi system containing 4n pi electrons. Anti-aromatic compounds are very unstable. In problem A, we have alternating single and double bonds, and we can see this pattern continues across two rings. We can draw a resonance form to show electron delocalization over the bicyclic compound. Remember, each of our representations is an average of the actual structure, although it looks like this bond has moved here, and this bond has moved to the other ring. Let's count pi electrons. Each double bond is made up of 2 electrons, so we have 2, 4, 6, 8 pi electrons in this system, which makes it anti-aromatic. Moving from a hydrocarbon example to a heterocycle with nitrogen atoms in the ring, we have a bit of a different situation. Each nitrogen has a lone pair, so we need to figure out whether or not they can participate in the pi system. It's helpful to look at a model for this one. We can see the blue double bonds and green single bonds, which is a reasonable representation for the pi system in this static model, even though in reality, delocalization makes each bond more like a 1.5 bond. Notice the geometry at nitrogen. Since it is sp2 hybridized, the lone pair must fit into this hole, which sticks out at a 120-degree angle to the other bonds. The pi system is delocalized above and below the ring, so the lone pairs on an sp2 hybridized nitrogen are orthogonal to the aromatic pi system. So this compound, called pyrazine, has 3 double bonds in the ring, making the compound aromatic, and it also has 2 orthogonal lone pairs. Problem C has a positively charged nitrogen. It has shared its lone pair to bond with oxygen, forming an N-oxide functional group. It has 4 bonds, which gives it tetrahedral geometry and makes it sp3 hybridized. The sp3 nitrogen atom disrupts conjugation in the ring, and this compound is non-aromatic. Problem D is an interesting example. Each oxygen has 2 lone pairs, so each atom in the ring has either a lone pair or is sp2 hybridized. However, this compound is non-aromatic as drawn. Let's examine why. We can show a resonance form by pushing electrons through the entire conjugated system, putting a negative charge on the oxygen outside of the ring and using one of the lone pairs of the ring oxygen. We had to push electrons in a path that led outside of the ring to show this resonance form. Thus, the conjugated system is not continuous within the ring, so the compound on the left is non-aromatic. Now the form on the right does indeed have aromatic character, but because of the charge separation, it contributes less to the overall structure. Also, our problem asked if the compound was aromatic as drawn. There's a second way to push electrons in this system, but it also relies on conjugation with the exocyclic double bond. In compound E, we again have an sp2 nitrogen with an orthogonal lone pair. If we look at the model of this compound, it is so strained that the double bonds are bending, but it certainly is planar. Since two double bonds make up the pi system, this is an anti-aromatic compound. This compound with a positively charged sulfur atom has three double bonds within the ring. So what about the lone pairs on sulfur? Sulfur is in the same group as oxygen on the periodic table. So only considering the valence sp hybrid orbital, we can draw a lone pair on sulfur that does not participate in the pi system. So this compound has 6 pi electrons and is aromatic. In our final example, we should recognize immediately that the nitrogen lone pairs are orthogonal to the pi system. We can draw 2 lone pairs on sulfur, one of which participates in the pi system. Geometrically, the second lone pair cannot participate, so it is outside of the pi system, though maybe not exactly perpendicular to it. Given the two double bonds in the ring and the lone pair on sulfur, compound G is aromatic.